Hello students, today I am here with a new topic, the land of dense forests. As you know that our earth is divided into three heat zones, the torrid zone, the temperate zone and the frigid zone. The regions around the equator experience hot and wet climate throughout the year. It is known as torrid zone. It results in a great biodiversity in the region. We will learn more about this region by considering the example of Democratic Republic of Congo. Earlier it was named as Zaire. First, I am going to discuss with you the location of the country. The Democratic Republic of Congo is located on the western side of Africa continent. Equator passes through the northern part of this country. You can see in the map of Africa the countries from which the equator passes through: Gabon, Republic of Congo, Uganda, Kenya and Somalia are the countries from which the equator passes through. A major part of the country basin of River Congo. Congo River is the second largest river in Africa. This river is also known as the Highway of Central Africa. Kinshasa is the capital of Democratic Republic of Congo. Now, I am going to discuss with you the climate of the country. Climate is very hot and humid. There is enough sunshine and rainfall in this region. The air is humid. The mornings are pleasant with bright sunshine. As a result of its equatorial location, the Congo experiences large amounts of precipitation and has the highest frequency of thunderstorms in the world. The annual rainfall can total upwards 200 centimeters. In some places and the other areas, sustains the second largest rainforest in the world after that of the Amazon. Such climate helps in the growth of thick forests with tall trees. The trees in this area grow very tall and form a canopy, preventing sunlight from reaching the ground. Therefore, Congo is sometimes called the heart of darkness. The crown is covered with shrubs and bushes. A large variety of trees grow in this region. About half of the country is covered with thick equatorial forests. The forests remain green almost throughout the year. They are called evergreen forests. The hardwood trees like mahogany and ebony provide raw materials for many industries. Students, now I am going to discuss with you the wildlife of this region. The rainforests of the Democratic Republic of Congo contain great biodiversity, rare and endemic species, such as both species of chimpanzee, the common chimpanzee and the bonobo chimpanzee. Bonobo chimpanzee, also known as pygmy chimpanzee. Mountain gorilla, okapi and white rhinos are also found here. Many parts of the forest have been cleared and the land is used for raising crops like rice, cotton, groundnut, coffee, rubber, cocoa, tobacco and palm. Cassava and banana are. Cassava, a root crop, is pounded to prepare flour, which is used for making bread. Some agriculture products like cocoa, coffee and palm oil are exported to other parts of the world. Students, now I am going to discuss with you the industries. The Democratic Republic of Congo is rich in mineral resources. The Congo is the world's largest producer of cobalt and a major producer of copper and industrial diamond. It has significant deposits of tantalum, which is used in the fabrication of electronic components in computers and mobile phone. In 2002, tin was discovered in the east of the country, but to date, mining has been on a small scale. Other minerals include cobalt, copper, gold, uranium, and silver. There are a few industries, and most of them are in or near the cities. The government is making efforts to develop the resources. There is plenty of water in the country. Dams have been built across the rivers to produce hydroelectricity. Now, I am going to discuss with you the life of the people. The country is thinly populated. Most of the people live in the villages. Most of them are Bantu-speaking Negroes. They are tall and hefty with dark skin. They follow a traditional lifestyle in the villages. Due to hot and wet climate, they wear limited clothes. They enjoy music and dance. In cities, the people mostly wear modern clothes and lead European lifestyle. A number of cities have been developed after independence. In the northern part of the country, the people are short in height and are called pygmies. They are nomads. Their huts are small and can protect their families from heavy rains. They are skilled hunters. They are fond of honey. Christianity is the majority religion of the people in Democratic Republic of Congo, followed by about 80% of the population. Transport in Democratic Republic of Congo has always been difficult. The terrain and climate of Congo Basin present serious barriers to road and rail construction, and the distances are enormous across this vast country. The Democratic Republic of Congo has thousands of kilometers of navigable waterways, and traditionally, water transport has been the dominant means of moving around approximately two-thirds of the country. This video, I discuss with you the lifestyle of the people living in the dense forest of Africa. Thank you for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed the session. Goodbye.